The next topic is the merits of public corporation. The merits and the good things which are in the public corporation are as follows. The first is administrative autonomy. Administrative autonomy, a public corporation is able to manage its affairs with independence and flexibility. There is a lot of flexibility while they are taking the decision in the organization. The public corporation is able to manage its affairs. Whatever inside the organization, what policies they are to be framed for working to the employees and how they have to take the decision and how they take the work with their subordinates, that is managerial administrative working autonomy is there. So they take their decisions according to the law. The next is quick decision. In this types of, this is a merit of the cooperative. This is a merit of the public corporation. In this, the quick decision making is there. A public corporation is relatively free for red tapism as there is less file work and less formalities to be completed before taking decision. While the decisions are faster, while there are a lot of formalities are not there, they take faster decision for the welfare of the organization to develop the organization. That is a merit which is needed in the organization for their development. And the next is service motive. Why do these types of organization are work under the guidance of the government? And so the government give the guidelines to provide the service and to get the maximum benefits for the society. That is service motive. The activities of public corporation are discussed in parliament. This ensures protection of public interest while all the public interests are protected under this head. So that also the merit of the service motive. The next is the efficient staff. While they are selecting the staff, they have a separate procedure of employing the recruitment process of the staffing. So there is a staffing process which is effective. They select the best and the appropriate candidate for the vacant post which is in the organization, in which post, what type of people and the qualifications they are to be authorized to select the best and the efficient staff. So the public corporation can have their own rules and regulation regarding remuneration and recruitment of employees. It can provide better facilities and attractive terms and services to staff to secure efficient working from its staff. While they are making these types of policies to get the best with their staff. The next is the professional management. While there are two words, one is professional and other is a management. Professionals are those which are qualified in their particular field, like manager, doctors, lawyers. They have a separate degree of their profession. And management is the art of getting the work done through other. So there are two words which are to be merged in professional management, means those who are working in these types of organization, they are professionals. So they take the good decision and their thinking is better and they forecast and plan in a best and efficient manner to how they take the work with their staff or subordinates. So they take the good decision for their welfare as well as how to take the professional management is there. So its board of director consists of business experts. So they hire the experts in their particular management field. So they are known as the professionals. And also the perspective of the various groups such as labor, consumers by the government and the labor, clubs, and there are different working staff in the organization from top level to lower level. They are select and hired by the professional management. So they work for the best for the staff. So they get the good result in the organization. Thank you.